Believe it or not, you can actually will it into existence. So it's, you gotta visualize being victorious.
Did you ever think your career would take you to NBC primetime to fight a Broner, a three-time champion?
Of course, but when it's here, it's exciting, man. It's very exciting. And that's my story, man. And the fans get behind me because I'm that long shot guy that made it here. You know,
you're like
I mean?
The Rocky.
Yeah.
From West Covina.
Yeah, from Covina.
Why? Not West Covina?
Not West Covina. Covina.
Hey, is he from West Covina or Covina?
Covina.
I said West Covina.
They're neighboring cities, but I am. But West Covina is cool too, man. They're right next door to us, but it's all about Covina. 626 Charter Oak High School, putting it on the map.
So if John Molina wasn't a boxer, what would he be today?
That's a good question, man.
No passion, nothing else.
No,
do you like animals? Do you like people? Do you like computers?
I don't know, man. I've been blessed with a career where I never had to really look into that perspective. So I don't know what I would do. Whatever I do, I'd be successful at it because the key to anything in life is sticking to it.
Yep.
So I'll be successful at anything I do, I believe.
What has you think been your biggest win in your career so far?
My biggest win in my career? My biggest win in my career was getting married and having my daughter. Because that really sets your perspective on life. But without them, why are we doing this? You know what I mean? Without your family, why are you here today?
That's your motivation.
It's the intangible motivations.
Who's your favorite athlete of all time?
I really like Magic Johnson, man.
Why?
Just ultra talented, great guy, business savvy. I mean, in his era, he was one of the best. Hall of Famer.
I was wondering what that was for. Now I figured it out.
That's
so Magic Johnson?
Magic Johnson.
Would you invite him to your fight?
Absolutely.
I've seen him at some fights.
I'm sure he'll be there. He's a big fight fan. But he's definitely a... You ever watch those 30 by 30s?
Yeah, of course.
They have some pretty interesting stories. You know, and you get to... Again, it's all face value because I never really met him face to face. I think I met him one time, but not enough to pick his brain.
I met him 50 times, but I still don't think he knows who I am. or at least maybe he's smart, so smart that he knows...
Well, you got to remember, he meets so many people... That are so in awe of him. It's hard for him to remember everybody.
How about this?
Did you know that Magic Johnson, right? As soon as he got his Simon bonus when he turned pro.
Yeah.
He immediately, the first thing he did was bought a radio station. But the radio station is like $1.6 million. So they tried to get every guy on the team to pitch in at least $100,000. All the guys said no.
Right.
He bought the whole radio station. Years later, he ended up selling a radio station for $30 million.
Wow.
This is before his Starbucks and all that.
How much did he buy it for?
Like 1.3, 1.4 himself.
Well, he's a smart businessman. His dad, I remember reading a book that his dad used to work in a garbage truck and used to help him and he had a very good work ethic.
He comes from a big
from
family.
Michigan.
He comes from a big family, actually. I think 9 brothers and sisters.
What part of Michigan? Lansing?
That's not right there, Cameron.
Yeah.
Okay. If they made a movie about John Molina, who plays him?
Good question.
Rob Schneider?
Yeah, I got a lot of acting friends. Rob Schneider, Adam Brody.
Adam Sandler.
Adam would be great, but I think I'm not funny enough to be Adam Sandler.
No, he could be serious. He did that movie with Jennifer Lopez. What was it called?
He could be very serious.
What was that movie? What's the movie Adam Sandler did where he was very serious?
Love
it was about with
Punch
Drunk
Love.
Yeah, Punch Drunk Love.
No, another one where there was like the help. He had like a...
The Babe?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, no. Spanglish,
that's what it was.
Spanglish, yeah. That was a great movie, actually.
You think
not as good as Punch Drunk?
You think if they did a movie about John Molina, Adam Sandler could play him?
Then that face tells you it all, right?
Maybe Nicolas Cage.
Okay, do you think Mr. T could play Malik Scott?
Oh yeah, they just look exactly alike.
No, a personality character. Okay, Malik, who would play Joe Goosen?
Look, right now Clark Gable's dead, so.
What about the guy that had the late show? What's his name?
The person that would play Joe Goosen would be Thurston Howell III. If you're not familiar, he's the millionaire from Gilligan's Island. Looks exactly like Joe Goosen.